Very good morning to you children. By exercise 8.1, I hope you have understood what are trigonometric ratios and how to take trigonometric ratios when a right triangle is given to you. Today's topic is trigonometric ratios for some specific angles. The specific angles here means the construction angles which you have already learned as 30 degree, 60 degree, 45 degree and as special cases of 0 degree and 90 degree. You have learned how to construct the angles of 30 degree, 60 degree, 45 degree and 90 degree. We are going to define the values of the trigonometric ratios for this particular specific angles. Let's go into detailed explanation. For 30 degree and 60 degree, the explanation is by using an equilateral triangle. Let ABC represents an equilateral triangle. And an equilateral triangle will always have equal sides and equal angles. That means angle B is 60 degree, angle C is 60 degree and angle A also 60 degree. Now, in this equilateral triangle, let us construct an altitude AD. So, let the side of the equilateral triangle, let us take it as 2A. You can also go ahead with A, but 2A, so that the calculation will be easy and for you to understand it will be very easy. That means let ABC represents an equilateral triangle, let AD be an altitude. Now you can prove or you know that triangle ADB will be congruent to triangle ADC by RHS, right angle, hypotenuse and common side, and so each of these angle here will be 30 degree. That means if I redraw the triangle ADC as angle A will take 30 degree, angle C will take 60 degree and angle D will take 90 degree. Also, AC length is 2A and by the property of an altitude of an equilateral triangle bisects the base, DC length will be A. Let us find out what is the length of AD, altitude, by Pythagoras theorem. That is, AD is equal to square root of AC square minus DC square, which is the same as square root of 2A the whole square minus A the whole square, square root of 4A square minus A square root 3A square, or it's the same as root 3A. And now using this figure can we write the trigonometric ratios for 30 degree and 60 degree by the definition of the sides. Let's write it as, let's form a table. The table, the values of 30 degree, the value of 60 degree and the trigonometric ratios. Let me call that particular angle as theta, whereas if it's coming under 30 degree, that it will be sine 30, cos 30 and so on. The order of trigonometric ratios, normally we go ahead with sine, cos, tan. That means either sine theta, cos theta, tan theta. So the first sine theta, cos theta, tan theta. Once you know the values of sine theta, cos theta and tan theta, The reciprocals are cosec theta, sec theta and cot theta. Let theta represents 30 degree in this tabular column or in this column. Let theta represent 60 degree in this particular column. Let's take the values. Sine, we are talking about 30 degree. Sine 30 is the same as, let's write detail here. Sine 30 is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse. Opposite side by hypotenuse, which is the same as 1a by 2a, or like the constant k, it gets cancelled. So sine 30 is 1 by 2. Similarly, let's take what is cos 30 is adjacent side by hypotenuse. The adjacent side is root 3a and hypotenuse is 2a, that is root 3a by 2a, or it is the same as root 3 by 2. And tan 30 is the same as opposite by adjacent, that is 1a by root 3a, or the value is 1 by root 3. The other values of cosec is the reciprocal. Cosec 30 is the reciprocal of sine 30, therefore it is 2 by 1 or 2. Sec 30 is the reciprocal of cos 30, it is 2 by root 3. And cot 30 is the reciprocal of tan 30, it is root 3. Similarly, let's take the values of 60 degree. 60 degree is an angle C position. Sine 60 is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse, which is the same as, for 60 degree opposite side is root 3a by 2a, it's the same as root 3 by 2. Then cos 60 is the same as adjacent side by hypotenuse, which is the same as 1a by 2a, or it is 1 by 2. Tan 60 is the same as opposite by adjacent, root 3a by 1a, or it is root 3 by 1 or root 3. Once you know the values of sine 60, cos 60 and tan 60, the reciprocals. Cosec 60 will be 2 by root 3. Sec 60 will be 2 by 1, reciprocal of cos. And cot 60 is the reciprocal, it is 1 by root 3. Thus, the values of sine 30, 1 by 2, cos 30, root 3 by 2, tan 30 is 1 by root 3, and just an interchange of the values for sine 60, it is root 3 by 2, 1 by 2 and root 3. So if you keep the table in your mind, the values are as 1 by 2, root 3 by 2, 1 by root 3. It's an interchange of root 3 by 2, 1 by 2, root 3, and the order we always maintain is sine theta, cos theta, tan theta. So that to keep memorized in your mind, it's very, very simple. And the geometrical proof or how to get the values is by this geometrical method. That means an equilateral triangle will be drawn and altitude will definitely bisect the base, and the angle will be divided as 30 degree here. You can apply the ratios of the trigonometric ratios in the particular position to get the values of some specific angle. Let's derive the values for 45 degree. For 45 degree, let's imagine a right triangle, and that too, it is an isosceles right triangle. Imagine triangle ABC is an isosceles right triangle, which gives you an idea that each side is A and
Since the two sides are equal, the two angles will add up to 90. At the same time, they are equal, which shows that each angle is 45 degree. Once you know the side AB and BC as A, AC will be square root of A square plus A square, square root of 2A square, or it measures root 2A. Let's take the measures as we have done the previous problem. Sine 45, any one of the angle you can take, both will give you the same answers. Sine 45 is equal to opposite by hypotenuse, A by root 2A, which is the same as 1 by root 2. So for 45 degree, sine 45 is 1 by root 2. Similarly, what will be cos 45 also? Adjacent by hypotenuse, it is the same as A by root 2A, or it stands again as 1 by root 2. What will be tan 45 is opposite by adjacent, which is 1A by 1A, or the answer is 1. Once you know the values of sine 45, cos 45 and tan 45, the reciprocal cosec 45 is root 2, sec 45 is also root 2, and cot 45 is 1. Thus, for easy memorization, in case you can memorize this triangle in your mind, but the position of the angles should not be changed. For that, you should have an idea in the mind that the equilateral triangle 60 degree. At the same time, the altitude is bisecting that angle too. So once this picture is in your mind, even if you forget the formula, you can, or the value, you can use this triangle to get the answer. Similarly, for a 45 degree, you can remember as 90 degree, 45, 1, 1 and root 2. This will give an idea for 30 degree, 60 degree, and this will give an idea for 45 degree. Let's see how trigonometric ratios of 0 degree and 90 degree has been derived by using the acute angles as shown in the picture. The first case of triangle ABC is right-angled and angle A is acute. In the first position, you can see angle A is acute. Second position, you can see that the angle A, the triangle, I'm drawing the line AC, you can see that angle A has reduced the magnitude. Similarly, when we see here, angle A has reduced again. Reduced by moving, you can see angle A is getting reduced and reduced and reduced, and here it got diminished, or the points B and C belong to the same point, or BC line. What is happening to the length of BC? The length of BC is getting reduced. That means when the angle decreases, the length of BC also decreases, and at the same time, when angle A is equal to 0 degree, the points B and C coincided, or length BC has become 0 units. That means the length of BC is getting reduced and reduced and reduced, and finally BC has taken, the line segment BC has taken 0 units. That means when you consider sine 0, when you take sine 0 in this triangle, sine 0 is equal to opposite by hypotenuse, which is the same as the opposite side BC has reduced into 0, and The hypotenuse, what happened is AC and AC coincided. AC is equal to AB is equal to 1 unit. That means the length AC got coincided with AB. Therefore, 0 by 1 or sine 0 is 0. What will happen to cos 0 is adjacent by hypotenuse, the length is AB by AC. Here I can point out as BC by AC, which is equal to both on the same line, or it is 1 by 1 or 1. And tan 0 has become opposite by adjacent, which is the same as 0 by 1, which is again 0. Thus, the values for 0 degree is sine 0, 0, cos 0, 1, tan 0 is 0. The reciprocals you can write, but normally we don't ask the reciprocals. You need to study only the sine 0, cos 0 and tan 0. And now, so once again I will tell you, angle A has reduced the magnitude. So when angle A reduces the magnitude, the length of BC also decreases, and when angle A becomes 0, BC coincides with AB, AC coincides with AB, that is hypotenuse coincides with AB. And now, in a similar way, let's discuss how the acute angle A is getting increased to reach 90 degree. Look at the picture position. Angle A shows a magnitude. Angle A is increasing. Here also angle A has got more and increased. You can see the magnitude is increasing, increasing, and finally angle A has taken 90 degree. So what is happening to the side AB? Instead of BC getting reduced here, AB is getting reduced by the length. So when angle A increases, the side AB decreases, and when angle A has become 90 degree, that means AB length has taken 0 units and BC length has taken 1 unit, because the AB, that AC and BC got coincided. That means the hypotenuse coincided with the length BC. And now, so AC length is also 1 unit. And now, if you take the ratio here, sine 90 is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse. Opposite side is BC, hypotenuse is AC, so it is 1 by 1, that is 1. Cos 90 is equal to adjacent side. Adjacent side is AB. AB is not existing. AC is existing as 1 unit, but it's coming as 0 by 1, which is equal to 0. And if sine 90 and cos 90, tan 90 is equal to 1 by 0 is not defined, as division by 0 is not defined. Thus, the values of 90 degree, sine 90 is 1, cos 90 is 0, and this is not defined. This is how we derive the values of 0 degree and 90 degree. Here BC is, AB length is 1 unit, AC is equal to 1 unit, AB is also 1 unit. You can just understand from the figure the values. The values have to be by heart. And to easily remember the values of this one, you can remember as sine 0 is equal to 0. Like a rhyming word, you can remember as sine 0 is equal to 0. Therefore, cos 0 is 1. therefore cos 90 is 0 and sin 90 is 1. It will be only alternate values of 0 and 1. Otherwise, if you remember as sin 0 is equal to 0, sin 90 is 1, cos 90 as 0 and cos 0 as 1. These are the two different ways of biharting, by only using the value of sin 0 is equal to 0, because the value only alternatively changes between 0 and 1. Let's proceed with exercise 8.2. I request the children, just by heart the values of sin 30, cos 30, tan 30, sin 60, cos 60 and tan 60 only. The other ratios you can take the reciprocals. No need of by hearting the full table as in the textbook. Only these values, and you know that it is only, as I told you, it's an interchange. So just only these 9 values and this 4 values you have to understand nicely and keep it in your mind before referring to this video on exercise 8.2. Then only it will be easy for you to work out. Exercise 8.2, question number 1. Evaluate the following. Sin 60 cos 30 plus sin 30 cos 60. Value of sin 60 is root 3 by 2. Cos 30 is also root 3 by 2 plus sin 30 is 1 by 2. Cos 60 is also 1 by 2. The two terms, root 3 into root 3 is 3 by 2 into 2 is 4 plus 1 into 1, 1 by 4. 3 by 4 plus 1 by 4 is equal to 1, or by LCM. The second one, 2 tan square 45 plus cos square 30 minus sin square 60. Tan 45 is 1. So tan square 45 is 2 into 1 square plus cos 30 is root 3 by 2, so root 3 by 2 the whole square minus, again sin 60 is root 3 by 2, root 3 by 2 the whole square, which is 2 into 1 plus root 3 the whole square is 3, it is 3 by 4 minus 3 by 4, positive 3 by 4 and negative 3 by 4 gets cancelled, or the answer is 2. Even if you forget this, if you take LCM, you will get the same answer as 2. Question number 3. Cos 45 divided by sec 30 plus cosec 30. See, in this exercise, the workout is just like fractions, LCM, and then the 9th standard concept of rationalizing the denominator to remove the irrational factor. So the method is as normal of finding LCM. Division by a fraction is multiplying by the reciprocal, and so on. Go systematically. There is no difference in your calculation as in arithmetic. Cos 45 is 1 by root 2 divided by sec 30 is the reciprocal of cos 30. Cos 30 is root 3 by 2. Therefore, sec 30 is 2 by root 3 plus cosec 30 is the reciprocal of sin 30. Sin 30 is 1 by 2. Therefore, cosec 30 is 2. So, the first step is over. Now, this 1 by root 2, leave it as such, divided by. You can see like a fraction here, take the LCM. The LCM is root 3. So here into 1 into 1, and here by 1 into root 3 into root 3. So it is 2 plus 2 root 3 by root 3. The next step, it's a fraction by a fraction, that means multiply by the reciprocal. So 1 by root 2 into root 3 divided by 2 plus 2 root 3. Next step is 1 into multiplication of fractions. Multiply the numerator, multiply the denominator. What is 1 into root 3? That is root 3 divided by root 2 into 2, or you can write one more step as root 2 into 2 plus 2 root 3. And now, which is the same as root 3 by, actually 2 can be taken out, but let's multiply, no problem, 2 root 2 plus root 3 into root 2 is root 6, so it is 2 root 6. The next step, you have to rationalize the denominator, which is the same as root 3 by common factors 2 into root 2 plus root 6. Multiply and divide by the conjugate. Why did we take out 2 is, 2 is already a rational number. Even if you don't do it, even if you multiply and divide with 2 root 2 minus 2 root 6, it will be the same procedure, the answer will be the same. Into root 2 minus root 6 by root 2 minus root 6. Numerator can be expanded as root 3 into root 2 is root 6 minus root 3 into root 6 is root 18 by 2 is already a rational number. It is always root 2 the whole square minus root 6 the whole square, which is equal to root 6 minus root 18 by 2 into 2 minus 6. Now, root 6 minus root 18 can be written as 3 root 2 by 2, 9 by 3, 3, 1. It can be written as 3 root 2. 3 root 2 by 2 into minus 4 is minus 8. When the denominator is negative, the standard form is always the denominator with a positive number. So, minus root 6 plus 3 root 2 by 8, or you can arrange as 3 root 2 minus root 6 by 8. This is the final answer of this question, 3 root 2 minus root 6 by 8. Subdivision 4, sine 30 is 1 by 2, tan 45 is 1 minus cosec 60 is the reciprocal of sine 60. Sine 60 is root 3 by 2. Cosec 60 is 2 by root 3. Divided by sec 30 is the reciprocal of cos 30. Cos 30 is root 3 by 2. Sec 30 is 2 by root 3. Plus cos 60 is 1 by 2. Plus cot 45 and tan 45 both are 1. After substituting the values, it is a fraction, take it as by 1. So the common LCM is 2 root 3. So the first term you will multiply with root 3. Second term fully with 2 root 3. And this term with 2. So what will be the numerator? Root 3 plus 2 root 3 minus 4 divided by the same LCM of 2 root 3, which is the same of into 2 into 2 into root 3 into root 3 into 2 root 3 by 1, 2 root 3. So the denominator is 4 plus root 3 plus 2 root 3, or 1 root 3 plus 2 root 3 is 3 root 3 minus 4 by 2 root 3 divided by 1 root 3 plus 2 root 3 is again 3 root 3, that is 4 plus 3 root 3 by 2 root 3. Fraction with a fraction is multiply by the reciprocal. 3 root 3 minus 4 by 2 root 3 into 2 root 3 by 4 plus 3 root 3. It's getting cancelled. Or 3 root 3 minus 4 by 4 plus 3 root 3, and 4 plus 3 root 3 is the same as 3 root 3 plus 4. Anyway, you can adjust. Let's take 3 root 3 minus 4 by 4 plus 3 root 3 into the conjugate is 4 minus 3 root 3, 4 minus 3 root 3. It doesn't make a change. Which is the same as how to multiply is 3 root 3 with 4 minus 3 root 3 minus 4 into 4 minus 3 root 3 by denominator is always a square minus b square. That is 4 square minus 3 root 3 the whole square. Which is the same as 4 3's are 12 root 3. Then 3 3's are 9, 9 3's are 27. Minus 4 into 4 is minus 16 plus 4 3's are 12 root 3 divided by 16 minus 3 square is 9, 9 3's are 27. So 12 root 3 plus 12 root 3 is 24 root 3 minus 27 minus 16 is minus 43 divided by 16 minus 27 is minus 11. Denominator should be changed into a positive denominator, that is positive 43 minus 24 root 3 by 11. That will be the answer of question number 1, subdivision 4. Subdivision 5, this is an important question, mark it as an important question. 5 cos square 60. 5 into cos 60 is 1 by 2 whole square plus 4 into sec 30 is the reciprocal of cos 30. Cos 30 is root 3 by 2. So 2 by root 3 the whole square minus tan 45 is 1. So tan square 45 is 1 the whole square. Sin square 30 is 1 by 2 the whole square. Cos square 30 is root 3 by 2 the whole square. So after substitution, 5 into 1 by 4 plus 4 into 4 by 3 minus 1 by 1 by 2 the whole square. 1 by 4 plus 3 by 4. That is 5 by 4 plus 16 by 3 minus 1 by 1 plus 3 by 4, same LCM. The next step, LCM of 4 and 3 is 12. So the LCM is 12 into 3 into 3 into 4 into 4 by 1 into 12 into 12. So 15 plus 16 4s are 64 minus 12 by 12 divided by 1 plus 3, 4 by 4 is 1. 15 plus 64, 5 plus 4, 9, 79 minus 12 by 12 divided by 1. 4 by 4 is 1. So 9 minus 2 is 7, 67 by 12. This question is very important. It can be asked as such for the examination. Question number 2, choose the correct answer and justify your choice. So let's work out and get the answer. 2 tan 30 by 1 plus tan square 30. 2 into tan 30 is 1 by root 3 divided by 1 plus 1 by root 3 the whole square. That is 2 by root 3 divided by 1 plus 1 by 3. The LCM is 2 by root 3 divided by 1, 3 plus 1, it is 4 by 3, which is the same as 2 by root 3 into 3 by 4, 2 and 4 gets cancelled. It is 3 by 2 root 3. I can again change this root 3 as root 3 into root 3 by 2 root 3, or the answer is root 3 by 2, and the choice is they had asked you sin 60, cos 60, tan 60, sin 30. So the choice is the value of sin 60. Sin 60. I hope it is clear. Next is 1 minus tan square 45. Tan 45 is 1 by 1 plus 1. 1 minus 1, 0 by 2, which is equal to 0. And now the next question is sin 2a and 2 sin a. Sin 2a means 2 into 30 degree. That means 60 degree. If angle A is 30 degree, sin 2a means sin 60. So they are asking you for which angle both the values are same. So what will be angle A? The choices given are 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree and 60 degree. Consider angle A as 0. Consider angle A as 0. So sin 2 into 0 is the same as sin 0 is equal to 0. And that is LHS. And RHS equal to 2 into sin 0. 2 into 0 is also 0. Therefore, the answer is A is equal to 0 degree. I will show you how to work out with 30 degree and all. Sin 2A is the same as sin 2 into 30, which is sin 60, which is equal to sin 60 value is root 3 by 2. What's the meaning of 2 sin A? 2 sin 30, 2 into 1 by 2, the answer is 1. See, it's a wrong answer. Same way with 45 degree. Sin 2 into 45 is sin 90, sin 0, sin 90 is 1. Whereas 2 sin 45 is 2 into 1 by root 2, or it is 2 by root 2. That's the meaning of the question. I hope it is understood. So angle A is equal to 0 degree. Tan 30 by 1 minus tan square 30. 2 into tan 30 is 1 by root 3 divided by 1 minus 1 by root 3 the whole square, 2 by root 3 by 1 minus 1 by 3, 2 by root 3 divided by 3 minus 1 by 3, 2 by root 3 into 3 by 2 is the same as 3 by root 3. Again, change it as root 3 into root 3 by root 3, or the answer is root 3 means the value is tan 60 degree. That is the choice of the answer from the choose the correct word. Question number 3, it's a very very important question. If it's given that tan of A plus B is equal to root 3. You have to just consider tan of which angle is root 3. That is tan 60 is root 3, that is known to you. Compare the angles, therefore A plus B is equal to 60 degree. Similarly, tan A minus B is equal to 1 by root 3. Tan of which angle is 1 by root 3 is 30 degree. You can compare A minus B as 30 degree because it is the angles mentioned here. You can solve the equation as adding plus B and minus B gets cancelled. 2A is equal to 90, or A is equal to 90 by 2, 45 degree. Substituting in one of the equations, 45 plus B is equal to 60 degree, or angle B is equal to 15 degree. This question can be asked for sine of A plus B is equal to 1 by 2. Any of the trigonometric ratios they can ask, this is the method. Compare the angles, the known angles with the value of the angles given to you.
so that it will be easy to solve. Let's discuss the true or false already. Sine of a plus b is sine a plus sine b, false. It's a false statement. The value of sine theta increases as theta increases. You can just double check with the answers, you know. Sine 0, 0. Sine 30, 1 by 2 increased. Sine 45, 1 by root 2. And sine 90 is 1. It is an increase. That means it is a true statement. The value of cos theta increases as theta increases. Cos 0 is 1. Cos 30 is the same as root 3 by 2. Cos 60 is 1 by 2. And cos 90 is 0. It is a false statement because the cos value is decreasing. Number 4. Sin theta is equal to cos theta for all values of theta. Sin theta equal to cos theta only for theta is equal to 45 degree, because sin 45 is also 1 by root 2, cos 45 is also 1 by root 2, but it is not true for all values, therefore the given statement is false. Cot A is not defined for angle A is equal to 0 degree. If angle A is 0, you should know what is cot 0. Cot is the reciprocal of tan. Tan 0 is the same as sin 0 by cos 0. Sin 0 is 0 and cos 0 is 1. Therefore, tan 0 is 0. So, what is cot 0? It is 1 by 0. It is not defined. So, it is a true statement. Now, by heart the values and work out the worked out examples in the textbook as more questions for practice. Since the textbook exercise, the questions are very few. You need to work out the worked out examples too for practice.